name. Amen. Savior splits the eastern sky. There's a body gonna rise up from the ground. And I'm gonna fly in my way. I'm gonna see with the eyes of the world. I'm going with the
eyes of
seen nothing yet, y'all. It's gonna be a good day. Gonna be a good day. Well, we're gonna stop right here and take the morning tithes and offerings for the church, and then later on today during the service we will be taking a special offering for Paul's journey. So of course you'll make your checks out to the Lord's Glory Church during that time, and everything will be good. We're gonna be taking up a special offering later for them. So. But right now is the tithes and offerings for the church, and I wanted to read a quick scripture out of Luke chapter 6 and verse 38, and it says this. It says, y'all know this one, give, and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. You can tell I worked in children's church. Will be put into your bosom, for with the same measure that you use, it will be measured back to you. And this morning, I want you to be aware of we reap what we sow. And so, if you know, it's important to stay generous, to stay open to giving, to stay faithful in your tithing, and watch God work. And He is faithful. You know, He is faithful to His word. So this morning, if you need an offering envelope this morning, you have offering envelopes in the pockets in front of you on the seat backs. And, well, hallelujah. We have announcements running on the screen about some cool things going on, and so be aware of those. Amen. It's all good. Praise God. So how are we going to do this? Are they going to sing while we fill them out? Yes, sir.
Singing.
got your envelopes ready. Raise them up. Lord, we just thank you for the opportunity to plant seed into your kingdom. We thank you for Paul's journey. We ask you to bless them as well, Father, and bless this church and bless each family here and those that aren't here today, Father. And we just thank you and praise you that you are an awesome God. In Jesus' name. Everybody said amen. And we'll let those buckets go on around. We're going to let the children stay in here for the service this morning. So they're going to enjoy this. So any children that are here, they can stay in and enjoy it.
Let me hear you out there. Amen. Praise the Lord. I hope everybody can testify to that this morning. If you can, if you don't feel like you've never been called out of your sin, listen, I want you to open your heart right now. Open your ears, and more importantly, open your heart right now. The Holy Spirit is in this place. He's here for one reason. That's to draw you closer to the Father today. That goes for Christians and non-Christians today. How many can say we all need to be closer to the Father? Amen. That's what the Holy Spirit is here for. So open your heart and let the message of these songs reach in and pierce that heart today. Let the Holy Spirit draw you to the Father. Let Him call you out of your sin today. That when you walk out of this place, you can say, I am redeemed today. I'm a new child in Jesus Christ today. Amen. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. Amen. Praise God. I really believe from the very beginning of time that God had all this mapped out. He had a plan that someday, somehow, He was going to get all of His kids. They were all going to be with Him forever and ever and ever. And this next little song we're going to sing for you, it's going to take you back. It may be a song that you've heard before, but it's definitely a song that gives us that plan of salvation. Yes. Sad was the scene there. The birds hushed their singing, and like a lamb he was humble to his father's own will. And I think of anybody else that would have died on the cross for you. I can't think of anybody that would love me enough to give their life for me. Amen. I'm so thankful that he did. I didn't deserve it, but I'm thankful that he thought I deserved it. Amen. Praise God. One of these days we're going to live in that place, and all of our situations, all of our trials, all of our burdens, no more sickness, no more death, all that's going to be gone. But until that day, we got to live in here in all this mess. Amen. And this old world's got all of that stuff in it.
there's nothing in the Word, not one single place in the Word, are you going to find that you're protected from any of that stuff. Christians are going to get that kind of stuff. Amen. We're going to find ourselves in those kind of valleys at times. It's just all there is to it. Here's the difference. If you are a child of God compared to not being a child of God, that when you are in one of those valleys, you have a promise that He is with you. Right? I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I'm right there with you. He didn't promise how long it'd take us to get to the mountaintop. He didn't say how long we were going to be in that valley. He just said, as long as you are, I'm with you, even to the end of the world. Isn't that good news? So that's an advantage that you Christian have over someone that's not a Christian, even this place or maybe looking across this world right now. That's an advantage that we have. We can call on Him any time of the day. He knows what we're going through anyway, but He likes to hear from us. So maybe there's some of you even right here this morning that's going through some of those things in your life. I want you to know something. God loves you. He loves you. He just didn't save you and then stuff you in a bottle and put you on a shelf somewhere up there and ever so often go dust you off. That's not our God. He'll see you through your situation. We have a brand new song that's just gone out to radio this month. It's on a new CD, and it's the fourth radio single that we put out off of that one CD. And I knew from the very beginning that when we had this song pitched to us, I knew from the very beginning that this song was going to be a song that needed to be heard. And radio gives us that opportunity that when they play that song, thousands of people, possibly millions of people, has the opportunity to hear that song. People that we may never have an opportunity to touch or sing in front of. And I said, Lord, this is a song that needs to be heard. Because as we travel all over this country, here's what we find. The church is suffering right now. That's you and me, folks. We're going through things. The old devil, he's winning some of the battles right now. He don't win the war, but he's winning some of the battles right now. And the church is suffering. And the church needs to be encouraged. The church needs to remember that God is on my side. No matter what I'm going through, He's there with me. And He can get me through these things. Amen. So this song reminds us that no matter what, we need to keep going. Amen. We put it on a shirt back there, and there's a crown on that shirt. And I looked up some situations for the crown, maybe the meaning of the crown. And we all know we've heard of the crown of glory and the crown of righteousness, and we've heard of those symbols before. But I looked up another definition of the crown. Was a crown of victory. I love that. Because we can have victory over our situations. Amen. Now at the base of that crown, we put a little scripture. And it's 1 Corinthians 16:13. And here's what it says. It says, watch. Stand fast or stand firm. Church says stand tall. In the faith, be brave, be strong. Boy, that's some good words in a little tiny scripture like that. So maybe even right now, if you're going through a situation in your life, watch for Him. Stand in the faith of Jesus Christ, that He's with you and He'll help you. Be brave. And be strong. And no matter what, keep keeping on for God. You listen as we sing.
Through.
on the sin. Saw that little church and decided to go in. Sat down in the back, ashamed of how I live. The preacher said, just ask and Jesus will forgive. Her end up felt so dirty, I had wandered far. The preacher said, don't worry, God loves you as you are.
Dirty and sin today, but listen, you can leave here clean and redeemed and saved this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. All righty. Well, I'm going to tell y'all, this is our very first time to be here and see some of y'all. This is your very first time to ever see Paul Journey. Let me see the hand. Praise God. Amen.
We're going to sell a bunch of them CDs.
Well, I hope so.
it's all new victims.
We ain't doing much this weekend. So. Amen. That's good. If you had seen this group about a year ago, I had a bunch of young guys up here. Yeah, it kind of looked like I was running a daycare center, I'll tell you.
Now it looks like you're running a nursing home.
That's not right.
But yes.
That's not right. I mean.
Don't look at me.
From diapers to the pens.
Oh, that's not right.
We have gotten a little older, I will say that. But anyway, let me introduce these guys to you right here. A guy singing tenor for us right now. He's been doing a fantastic job. He has sung in your groups several ministries and actually had a ministry of his own not long ago. But the Lord has guided him here, and I'm so glad that he did. Out of Fort Worth, Texas, that's our tenor singer, Ron Higgins, right there.
Good morning, y'all. Thank you.
Guy here is much like Ron. He's sung in a few groups, several groups, and full time as well, and sings lead for the group. He's also very talented. He can play several different instruments. We're so glad that helps us when we're doing revivals. As far as our praise band and everything, it really helps us. He does that and leads that, and we appreciate him so much. Just been a wonderful add to this ministry, and I'm so thankful. Lives out in McKinney, Texas, and that's Keith Gillum right there. So. And I was telling Brandon, this group started, this ministry started back in Louisiana a long, long time ago. And in 1995, I believe it was, when we moved, our office moved everything here to Texas. We've been here since 1995. And it's been that long since I'd had another Louisiana guy in the group. Till about 2.5 years ago, God sent me one. This is our little Raging Cajun right here. He's out of Jennings, Louisiana. He's our baritone singer, and he's been doing a fine job for about those 2.5-plus years. Y'all make him welcome. That's Brad Davis right there.
And singing the bass right here, this group has been going for 40 years now, and he's been here all 40 years. Got a lot of miles on you, don't you? Yeah, he says he feels it too. But singing bass, doing a great job leading this quartet for those 40 years. That's Rod Trimmie. You glad to see Rod? Hey, here's a song we had out on radio last year, and great little message. You know, we believe it's time for the church and the Christians to stand up for the Word of God. Amen? And that's simply what this song talks about. That's why we sent it out, to get that message out. It's a fun little song, but a great message. It says, that's God's story, and I'm sticking to it.
Sticking to it, amen. That should be the, I don't know, the motto of every Christian in the world. I'm sticking to the gospel of Christ no matter what, amen. And if we did that, I mentioned to you the church was suffering. I tell you what, if it's the church's own fault, by the way, that we're suffering, amen, because we don't have to suffer, right? Wouldn't I tell you about that Holy Spirit being around us? He's the one that keeps us from all this suffering, amen. We just need to invite him in our lives a little bit more. But stick to the gospel of Christ, and if we did, I really think we could see a change in this world. But the church is going the opposite direction. Amen. It really is. All righty. That's enough preaching. Some of y'all may or may not know that Gary traveled with us for about 6 months or more, right, Gary? Yeah. And he filled in for me. And I'm going to tell you something. It was at a time when we really needed something. I had one of my young guys was getting married. We got married, and he moved, right? Yeah, he moved. And then I had another one that was going to get married, and he was going to move. And that was two positions I was having to fill, and I asked Gary if he'd come fill in on the tenor. And I said, you know, how long can you stay? And he said, well, how long you need me? Well, you don't ask an owner of a quartet how long you need him, amen. Because you just work, I work him to death, you know. I just, so, but I'm glad he was able to stay with us at least 6 months, and I'm so thankful because what it did, it allowed me some time to just put it in God's hands, to get the right people in this group. And I'm so thankful he did. And Gary sung with it, and I'd love for him. Would y'all like to hear Gary sing with the group? Come on up here, son. I don't know how he's going to do because he don't have, you're just going to have to get down there and hear it.
Okay.
We don't have no monitor up here. All right. So, but he can do this. This won't be a problem all for him. He did a song, and actually it's off the new CD. And I want him, that's one of them that I want him to sing with us today, that because I love the way he sang this song, because he sang it with so much heart. And I know the reason he did that is because he feels the message of this song is we all should. Because there was a time in each of our lives, and there still may be, I go back to this, there still may be somebody here or somebody that's listening or watching on video or whatever, that right now, more than anything else in this world, you need a Savior. Yeah. Amen. And Jesus Christ is our Savior. And I'm so glad that when I needed him the most, I didn't have to go hunting for him. He was there. Amen. So I want Gary to come sing a very beautiful song. It says, I needed a Savior. Sing it to him.
Oh,
how about singing one more before I pray? This is a little song that we took out of a hymnal. And that's a book that's got songs in it. Yeah. Some of y'all ain't seen them in a long time, have you? But anyway, this is an old hymn, and we kind of did it and put a little Paul's Journey twist on it. And so even if you ever saw or sung this song, you probably never recognize it. So, but we're going to try it for you. I love the meaning of this. It said, Lord, just make me a blessing. Amen. Let's do it. Started over here and he ended up way over here.
I think we got that right that time.
He just needed a little bit of break. That's all he needed. Because as long as he was with us, he never got it right. Amen. Praise God. He did good on that, though. All righty. Now, we are what you consider a Southern Gospel Quartet, and I don't know how familiar you are with that, but. Southern gospel goes back in the days of the 40s and the 50s. So some old songs, right? Do any of y'all ever remember any of them old quartet songs? Y'all like some of that? The classics? Some of y'all remember them, don't you? Yeah.
Yep. And old people like old songs. I've been trying to tell you that.
That's not what you don't need to say.
That's who raised their hand out there. That's
We don't like to be called old. That's number one.
Well,
you
I
need
know,
to remember
but
that.
It is what it is.
It is not what it is. If you're going to call us anything, call us classics. All right.
Classic. No, I got a better one than classics. Antiques.
That's no. Get back there. Back up.
Stick him in the corner.
You don't come in. This is a brand new church. You don't come in here and insult these people like that, especially before the offering. like them too. We've got, in fact, a series that we do, and it's called A Tribute to the Classics. So in every song in the series, and there's now three CDs, three volumes in the series, and every one of them is a request by someone. Someone's come up to us and said, would you, you know, put, this is my favorite hymn, like, you know, something like that song we just sang, but we didn't change it like we changed that one. Or this is my favorite quartet song or something like that. And they come up to us and we try to get it on the CD for them and everything. And do y'all mind maybe if we do a couple of those? Would that be okay? We're going to do it anyway. But this one right here, it's an old, there was a quartet back there started in the late 40s. 1948 actually is when they started. And they went for a long, long time. Or almost, I think, the year 2000 really is when the year they finally came off the road. But they were called the Statesman Quartet. And they, of course, got a lot of these great old songs that people remember back in then. This is one of them right here. You may not ever heard this one, but we'll try to do this one like the Statesman did. Okay, we'll try.
I do not want.
meant to tell you, people would come up to us or email us or something, and they would talk about a song, their favorite songs, and we'd do our best to put it on a CD. There's sometimes we didn't. And because, you know, whatever reason, maybe we didn't like the song. So there was a lady came up to me one time, and she said, Rod, this is my favorite quartet song, and y'all would do a fantastic job, and we appreciate you putting it on that CD. This was actually when we were going to do the very first CD. This was back in 2010 or 11, somewhere in there. And she told me the name of the song, and of course, I'd heard it many, many times. We had never recorded it. There was a reason. I didn't want to learn the words to it, so we didn't put it on that CD. And when she saw that CD came out and her song wasn't on there, she was upset. So I said, ma'am, maybe we can get your song on volume 2. And I'm going to have to be honest with y'all. This morning I had to repent on that one. I had no intention of putting that song on volume 2, because I still didn't want to learn the words to it, and we didn't. And when volume 2 come out and she looked back there and her song went, she was very upset then. And she let me know about it too. So.
Good for her.
So I said, ma'am, I promise you, I guarantee you, your song's going to be on volume 3 somehow, some way. We got it on there. Now, to be honest with you again this morning, I still don't know if I know all the words of this song. In case I mess it up, it's on volume 3 back there in that rack. Right? But we're going to try our best. Now, this one was written back in probably either the late 40s or early 50s by a guy by the name of Stuart Hamlin. So we'll see how this one turns out. Some of y'all may recognize it. Some of you may not. We'll see.
This old house once knew my children. This old house once knew my wife. This old house was home and comfort as we fought the storms of life. This old house once rang with a light through. This old house heard many shouts. Now she trembles in the darkness when the night wind walks about. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more. Shaky. This old house is getting old. This old house lets in the rain, and this old house lets in the cold. On my knees I'm getting chilly, but I feel no fear of pain, cause I see an angel peeking through a broken window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more. Else he'd wake up by the fireplace and he'd sit there howl and grieve. But my hunting days are over, ain't gonna hunt no coon no more. Hey, but I brought down my chair and when the wind blew down the door. Ain't gonna need this house no longer, ain't gonna need this house no more.
I mean, y'all having a good time here today. Let me hear you then. All right, so now's a good time to take up an offering, amen? While you're feeling good, amen. Praise the Lord. Pastor's going to come up here. I just want to remind you about this. We are a full-time ministry. This is what we do. We travel all over this country. God has opened up doors for us in 5 different countries around this world that we've been able to go and share the gospel of Jesus Christ. We've had the opportunity in these 40-plus years to see thousands of people come and give their hearts and life to Jesus. That's what it's all about for us, amen? Being full-time, this is what we do to support our families. I'm not going to lie to you about that. But what you're going to do today to bless this ministry, this is the most important part of what we do. The money that you will help this ministry with, we're going to take that, and we're going to go to the next place, wherever that may be. In this case, it's down in the Rio Grande Valley. That's where we're headed, the middle of the week next week. We'll be down there for about 3, 4, 5 days. We're going down there with these thoughts in mind to lift up the name of Jesus and to tell them the gospel. Deliver the gospel of Jesus Christ to those folks. Who knows? While we're down there, somebody may get saved. Amen? Right. If that's the case, I want to tell you something. What you do here today, you'll be blessed by it because you helped send the gospel there. You may not be there, but you helped to send it. Amen? So we want to thank you ahead of time this morning for what you're going to do to bless this ministry, to help us go spread the gospel across this country and this world. Thank you so much.
How many of you have been blessed here and are just enjoying this? And amen. I want to read to you a scripture that really all of us love to quote. We love to read it. It's a very popular scripture and a wonderful scripture in the Word of God from 3 John, verse 2. This scripture says, "Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be in health just as your soul prospers." And we love to claim that. I do. I know you do. All of us do. But we need to put it in context, too. We need to say, you know, who is the Lord talking to here when he says, "Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be in health just as your soul prospers." And I want to skip on over to verse 5 and read to you verses 5 through 8. "Beloved, you do faithfully whatever you do for the brethren and for strangers who have borne witness of your love before the church. If you send them forward on their journey in a manner worthy of God, you will do well, because they went forth for his name's sake, taking nothing from the Gentiles. We therefore ought to receive such that we may become fellow workers for the truth." So really, this blessing that we love to quote is addressed to Christians who believed in sending Christian ministers on in a manner that is worthy and of their service to the Lord. And it's up to us. They're going to the valley this next week and going to be ministering down there, blessing people down there, bringing the gospel in song and word. And it's up to us to send them forward in their journey in a manner that is worthy of God. And if we do that, we will do well. And then we'll be able to say with faith and conviction that we may prosper in all things and be in health just as our souls prosper. And when we quote that scripture, we can say that with sincerity of heart and with faith. So let's be people of the Word, people of God's Word, and let's give according to these scriptures. And I'd just like to ask all of you, I know we have a less than we had hoped to have. I guess maybe the ball game may have impacted us some. But you know what? Let's just all of us that are here dig a little deeper. And let's really be a blessing to this wonderful a group that God has brought to us, Paul's Journey. And so you can... of course, use the envelopes in front of you or behind you. And again, let's dig deep. Let's send them on in a manner that is worthy of God. Make the check out to the Lord's Glory Church. And I guess maybe would y'all like to sing while they... let's just pray over them. Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be in health just as your soul prospers. In Jesus' name, be blessed as you give.
Thank you so much. We appreciate that. While you're taking the offering, to take an opportunity real quick to tell you about what we do have on the table back there. Rod has mentioned we have the Tribute to the Classics series, three in that series right there. It's like 33 songs in total. A lot of great, great old songs on there that you'll know and recognize, and maybe even a few that you won't know right off the top of your head. But good collection there. Favorites through the years. We have favorites through the years, 15 of our top charted and favorite songs, like Come Dirty, Leave Clean, He Called Me Out, Leave Me to the Rock, songs like that. And then Keep Keeping On is our latest new release of new songs. That's God's Story, I'm Gonna Rise, and of course Keep Keeping On is on that. They're $15 a piece, or we do have a package for 40. It's the classics and the, yeah, somebody said, ooh, yeah, I like that, thank you. sometimes I say that and people just look at me. And I tell them it's wrapped up in a rubber band, and the rubber band's free too, so that kind of, you know. But it is four CDs. It's the classics and the favorites. It's almost 50 songs, just $40 in that package. The T-shirt, Rod's already talked about that, but show that to him real quick. There you go. Stand tall. It's about my size, I think. Stand tall and keep keeping on. That is great witness wear right there. They are also $15 a piece up to the 2 and 3X. 2 and 3X, just a couple dollars more. Or the other deal you can get, a shirt. You got the wrong CD there, Bubba. It takes a while to train these guys, you know. I call them the new old guys. That's what I thought that was pretty good. But anyway, $15 a piece, you can get a shirt and that CD that goes with it for $20. And then we also have bracelets. It's personal. It's personal. We got a new song coming out written just for us. Talks about its personal relationship with Jesus Christ is personal, right? And that's what that's talking about. And we got all kind of colors. They're $2 a piece if you'd like to buy some, or if you get that $40 package. Another bonus is you get a free bracelet. Thank you. Thank you. That's down home we say it just gets gooder and gooder, you know. this card right here, let me show that to them good, because sometimes people get confused. This card right here is for our email list. We haven't done it for a while, but this year we started back a monthly email newsletter. And it tells you about the group, tells you about things going on, tells you about special trips we go on every year that you can be a part of. There's a little devotional in there. So if you'd like to get on that, it's absolutely free. Just fill out that card. There's another sign-up sheet back there. And what it's for is like church references. If you know of somewhere that would like to have us, you think you can write that down. And we'd appreciate that. So thank you all for coming. Thank you for taking some of that music home. We're going to do another old song for you here, pretty old song. It was written in the early 80s, so it's pretty old.
That's old,
it's pretty old, but I tell you, I love what this song says. And to be honest, used to it didn't mean a whole lot to me. It's just another song. It's a classic song, but it was just another song kind of to me. And over the past about year and a half, my grandparents both got cancer and passed on, and I went to heaven. Grandpa went just a few days before Christmas. We had to go have his funeral, I think it was the day before Christmas Eve. And, man, that's made heaven a whole lot sweeter, amen? And there's a line in this song that just hit me the other day. It says, I'm looking now across the river to where my faith will become sight. You ever catch that right there? The faith that we cling to now of things yet unseen. We haven't seen Jesus. We haven't seen heaven, but we cling to that faith. And one day, when we cross that river and we wake up on the other side, our faith will become sight when we see that land we call Beulah Land. You listen.
this morning, and I've mentioned on several occasions here today that my prayer is that everybody in here is a child of God today, and if you're not, then you don't have to leave here that way today, amen. It's very important that you are, and we've shared some of those things with you, just to know that God is with us, amen. I mean, that's enough right there. And to know that when we call out his name, he hears us. Yeah. Amen. Tells us in his word, in Jeremiah 29:12 says that when you call upon my name, it says, I will listen to you. I love that as a Christian today, that I know that when I call upon his name, that he hears me. It also says that our name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, and that he knows our name so that when we call upon him, he not only hears us, he knows our name. It's personal.
He knows my name.
When I
That's good news this morning for every born-again Christian in this place today. That when you call out his name, he hears you, and then he knows who's calling. And he knows you personal. Amen? That's kind of what these little bracelets are about. It's a personal relationship with our Lord and Savior. There's not another religion on the face of this earth that can claim that. Old Muhammad over there, he don't know none of those boys. And they're killing for him, amen? He don't know them. And Buddha, he don't know them. He don't know any of those people. You know why? Because they're dead. But our Savior, he's alive. Give him praise this morning, amen? He's alive. And he knows you. And that one who died for you, he is now risen, and he's on the right-hand side of the Father, and he's making intercession for you. And when you call upon their name, he hears you. And he looks over to his Father, and he says, Dad, they're calling us. They have a need. Pastor Babbitt, he's calling us. He has a need. Hear him? See, that's what's good, folks. That's what we have over the world. And if you're not a child of God in this place today, you can have that too. So I encourage you today, whatever that need may be, include your Lord and Savior today. Include God into that. Whatever your situation may be. Maybe we go back to that battle that we were talking about a while ago in that valley. And maybe you're in it right now. And it could be physical. It could be emotional. It could be spiritual. It could be financial. It could be a broken marriage. It could be anything. You're in that valley right now. Come to an altar. Call upon the name of the Lord today, not tomorrow, right now, today. And say, God, I know you're with me, but I want to feel your presence. Wrap your arms around me. Help me. And I want to tell you, folks, I can't promise you. I will not promise you. I will not guarantee you that when you come down to an altar of prayer that you're going to get that answer just like that. I'm not going to do that. But here's what I am going to do, and I can promise you this. Whatever your need may be, no matter how big nor how small, whatever your need may be, if you bring it to God today, lay it at his feet today. When you get up from that altar and you leave it there with him, you're going to feel 150% better than you did when you walked in this place. For no other reason, you'll know that God's got my back. Include him today. That's what he's waiting for. He knows your situation. He knows everything about you. He knows the very hair on top of our heads. There's a couple of you in here, he don't have to know too much about you, but that's okay. He knows everything about you. He's just waiting for you to include him. That's what he's waiting for. So we're going to have a time of altar. I want to invite you during this time. I want you to feel free to come down to an altar of prayer. If you're lost in this place, there's people here that can help and pray with you. If you have a special need in your life, there's people that will pray with you. If you need healing in your body, there's people here that will pray with you today. But the main thing is before we leave this place and go to our homes, the main thing is that we turn it over to God today, right now. Amen? So y'all stand with me today. Guys, y'all going to sing something? As they sing and God speaks to your heart. Remember, the Holy Spirit is here. So there's no excuse. The Holy Spirit is here. Open your heart to Him. Let Him draw you closer to the Father right now. If you're that one that needs salvation, don't leave this place lost in this place today. They call this Super Sunday. If you leave this place saved today, it's greater than any Super Bowl on the face of this earth. I want to tell you, that little move in your heart will be greater than any Super Bowl that's ever played. This would be your Super Sunday right here. So you give it to Him today. As they sing and God speaks to your heart, you come today, all right? You start coming. Come on. Fill these altars up. Let's go. Truly mean it, if you surrender all to Him today, then I want you to sing out. If you can't surrender it all to Him today, then you're no sense in singing. Yeah. Amen. Unless you really mean it, let's sing that chorus today.
Give Jesus a hand clap, and also Paul's journey, and how many of you were blessed here today? Amen. Praise God. Well, we want to remind you, we are having our prayer service tonight at 6 p.m., and we welcome you to come back for that, and God bless you. How many of you would like to have Paul's journey back again? Amen. Praise God. Amen. We want to thank you so much for coming. God bless you. Don't forget, they have a table right back here with albums and T-shirts and wristbands and all kinds of good things there. Be sure and partake of that. And that way you can also bless their ministry and be blessed as well. Well, thank you so much for coming out. God bless you. Have a wonderful Sunday afternoon. We love you. And we'll see those of you that can come back tonight at 6.